Where, hey, Saad, do you know where I can see how much longer? Never mind. Forget it. I see it. Okay, cool. Two turns. There's no reason for me to summon.
You woke him
off. No problem. I knew if I called for you, my brain would be kicked into high gear by that action.
It's not, I have a question for you.
Yep.
What happens if you starve your people for too long?
Didn't you ask this question before?
Eventually,
I didn't answer
it depends
though.
On how bad the starvation is. They won't just basically produce population, so the city becomes stagnant. And you also gain unrest.
So unrest and population decrease.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Bad stuff.
Yeah, jacked up stuff.
How long does it take for influence to grow, did you say?
It's a city population size thing. I think it's 5 and 10.
Okay.
I don't know where to find that. Let me see if I can.
Wait, why do I have starvation? What? Oh, I need more.
Are your people starving?
I need more food.
You need more farms, son.
I do need more farms. Well, this fertile lands thing will make that really helpful as soon as it's finished. And that should be done, just for the record, in another 5 turns.
I think I'm going to finish here when I start my turn.
God, man.
I got to figure out what spell to get next then.
Okay. They lose the icon other times. Okay, cool. Thanks, Lo. All right. So I definitely, yeah. I mean, Fertile Plains.
Got to heal him somehow. How do you do that? I feel like an idiot because I can't see how it works. And this is an elf, so it's a living thing. I don't get it. Why don't I see how to heal this guy?
I like how when you click on something which can't be done yet, they've got things. It's like, you know, you don't have sufficient population. Also, there's a building already in progress. It's like all the possible reasons. It's like there are just so many reasons why you can't do this.
Yeah.
Like, just,
yep.
Why you're even asking is beyond us. Okay.
Okay, let's do this.
Okay, guys, I'll be back in just a couple minutes. I'm going to go downstairs and walk the dog, grab some water, and bring up some food. So I will leave on the game as that happens.
Sweet.
Stand and fight!
Oh, why is this... okay. All right, so I'm going to build my thing right there. Right there. These guys are going to go back here. Right. I think so. Oh, what the heck? Oh, they already moved. Hi, Bo. What you doing, buddy?
Well, the problem is, the bowmen I want to heal are elves, so they're living creatures, and I don't understand why I'm not finding the heal icon thingy, which I would heal them, absolutely. So it's rather annoying. The pop growth, oh, that's something else. Is that a... Oh, it is a land bridge.
Ooh.
Okay. Crows!
I found an ogre.
Uh-oh.
Did you?
I ain't going near him.
Yeah, be approached with mucho caution. Mucho freaking caution.
I'm just kidding, dude. I'm going for it. Man, screw it.
With what, crows?
Yes.
Oh, that'll take him.
No,
are you counting crows?
And they defeat him. That'd be hilarious. That would be hilarious.
Yeah.
Get him.
Take him on with archers. All right, and the settler is going to go. Russia.
Wild serpents. No,
actually,
no boundaries.
Where would be a place to build next? I mean, that's pretty much got it on lockdown. Donkeys are not a big deal. Unless I build a city here and a city here.
Oh my god, Nora is so cheap. That is awesome.
Don't worry about that yet. Let's bring this guy over. And I think that's going to do it. Because my farm is building. I'm not going to build any more units. Right. Yeah, let's not do that. Let's not do that. Okay. I think I'm done. Do I want to do it, though? Do I want to do it? I think I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm doing it.
Sending your crows in? Is that what you're doing?
No, I'm trying to decide whether it's worth it to...
You could build a shrine of the rotten pumpkin. That's amazing. Oh. Here's where I see if I finally get to finish this.
Because I can at least bring those over. I'm going to build a...
Sweet. Nice. Oh, you got him.
Oh, level up unit.
Your pigs are honking.
Okay, now, do I attack it? Do I take it over? What do I do with this building here?
Sod, he wants to take Zabuino. How does Optic do that?
Not so much take it. Okay. I don't want the penalties. I just want to loot it,
awesome,
basically.
Gabriel.
Oh, well.
You don't really loot it, but what happens is, see the green bar below it? That's the city strength. Once that reaches zero, you can just walk in and take over. And then you get the choice of, then you open up the city panel and you can choose to destroy it or just keep the city and build it up. You get penalties. They get a 50%, I think it's like a 50% population growth reduction, and you get a bit of unrest.
I'm sure the rattlings would be fine for them. It wouldn't be a bad thing.
Destructor.
Ooh, wow, they still have some defenses. He lost a guy. Critical hit. Oh, nice. Okay, I guess you're gonna take it over a lot faster than I thought.
Is that all? That's it. That's all I can do, right?
Probably.
How's Wildstar, Cadron? I've heard mixed reviews on it.
So, close, that doesn't work. He has nothing here. There's nothing. Niche. No heal. All right, I am very annoyed that I cannot figure out how to heal this guy. Apparently the elves don't have healing magic, is all I can think of. That's all I can decide, is that this doesn't work. All right, fine, whatever. Do I have a problem with these? Let's see.
Did you buy your elves secondhand?
Maybe. Boom! Oh, that was sweet.
Very nice.
Elemental damage. Kaboom. All right, now I'm going to go do some sniping here. Did you guys... Oh, nice. Two with one shot. Dang, that guy is awesome. Worth every penny I pay him.
This game is so intense, dude. As far as what all this crap you can do. What are the races in this game? There's a couple.
It's five, I believe.
Yeah,
oh,
they all have...
Okay.
Oh, wow.
I just figured it out. Except... It's still only 4 points. Doesn't that give me more? But I got a couple more guys now, so that's good. All right, can't fire anymore. Can't shoot him. Let's move you down here.
Honestly, the best thing to do on the races, since I don't really know exactly what they all do, is just look it up. Just Warlock 2 races, and they all have different things that they're better at and worse at. You know, we're all playing as a different class, though. Right. So John right now is playing as Undead. Arb is playing as, I think, pretty much the humans.
Who have apparently allied, my undead have allied with the elves for some reason. It's a little weird, but oh well, I'll take it. It's no big deal.
Yeah. Optic is the ratmen. And I'm like the half machine class of race.
Okay. So. Oh, my skeletons! Get out here! Actually, you know, maybe I should leave you guys to... Except you can't attack anything. That doesn't make any sense. I'll leave another unit of skeletons up there later, but my tower apparently can blast those lizards out of the sky all day long, so what do I care? All right, it's about time to start kicking some butt over here, and you must stay happy. And I can't do anything with him.
Gecko, is that the reason, man? Lord Sloth, what's up, man? Welcome in. Yeah, I'm the steampunk magic of dwarves. That's me. Yeah.
Okay, you just hang there for a while. You'll be back up just in case. Well, can't go there. But I could put you there, couldn't I? That's kind of a risk. Well, screw it. Almost dead. 24 points. Hope he doesn't come and bash me. That would suck. But they seem to just be sitting there. So I'll take the risk of losing my guys, which is probably what's going to happen. All right, my turn is over. Unknown Great Mage. Neutrals. Monsters. Oh, he just healed himself. Oh, that's not going to fly. Oh, crap.
All right.
What the heck, man?
You want to watch me pita chips? I'm sure you do.
There we go.
Okay.
This game is still a little buggy, I will say. But
ooh, wow. Kablammo.
You got some why? There's some bugs going on?
I don't know, like some of the menus seem to be like lagging behind a little bit whenever I click on it.
Oh, that's interesting. Hmm.
Do you guys have that?
I haven't had that yet.
Not really.
Oh, really? Okay. Confirmed. I don't know then.
Critical hit.
So these guys are full up on health because they haven't moved yet and... I don't know.
Take him out.
Disband, yeah. That's what I want to do is disband my bears now. Why can't you just reach out your giant awesome paws over the ocean?
Destroy them all.
That's... Oh, well.
One of them just leaps into the ocean and dies. With their giant armor on, they just sink.
Turns out he's actually good friends with the Kraken, so he just high-fives him on the way.
It was released 2 months ago? That's probably not changing then. It might be on my side.
I can't do it. Damage. I want to take out those giants while I have the chance.
Ugh, settlers are so slow. Okay. Let's see. Meanwhile, the harbor continues. One more turn to the harbor.
Oh, really, Sloth? Yeah, we're still on world one.
I do have plenty of money now. I do have plenty of coin, but... I don't know. I just desperately need a farm. So I wonder what happens if I'm going to keep losing people. Oh, okay. All right. I'm only losing a few from starvation, so I am still going up and pop. Okay. I thought I was actually losing population overall, but I'm not actually. So. Okay. Cool. All right. Well, that was not a very interesting turn. Four turns left for fertile lands. Huzzah. You cannot rest adjacent to an enemy unit. You got to back off a hex. That's helpful for keeping Krakens from healing. Oh, well, then I'll just leave my bears there. That's fine. I didn't know that. So, like, the Kraken's trying to rest, and my bears are like, grow. Just as a Kraken.
Oh, wait, you
like,
can't reach out rest off, when you're next to an enemy?
Bruh.
No.
Okay, that's good.
Hey, Zemaria, what's up, man? Just every so often, they're just like, bruh, bruh, bruh. Pause across the water. Pause across the water. All right, these guys
what are the glyph slots for spells?
When you pick up, when you kill, like, loot things and sometimes do quests and stuff, you get glyphs, and you can equip them into the spell to buff the spell.
So it'd be like, cost less or take less time to cast?
Yeah. Yep.
So you basically just spend money then, Sod, on units and,
upkeep.
And upkeep?
Yeah, there are some spells that let you convert gold to other things. And, you know, things like that. But they're higher level spells. I haven't gotten that far yet.
I'm wondering if I should just create another settlers then and go south. Because I think I'm going to do that. It costs 50 gold, but I'll still have 60 left. So, all right, I'm going to do that. Okay. Assign unit orders. What? Your order is to... actually, that's true. Your order is to defend. I should actually be doing that, I think. Rather than just, like, skipping the turn. Defend.
Four, so
and that's it. End turn. Cool.
All right. New spells been researched.
That Kraken has a lot of hit points. I just got a network error.
Oh, no. Someone dropped.
Optic. Blah, 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 blah. I can save the game and try to restart it.
Please do.
Fraction. Blah, 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 blah. Disconnected. All right. All right. I will save that. I do like the fact that you can, like, save load. I mean, I guess it would have to be that way, but the way that multiplayer games sometimes save is very dicey at best, so. Okay. Let me... move out of this.
Exit the game, my lord.
Yes, but I'm not exiting out of everything because I'm not resizing that again. All right. Multiplayer. Connect.
So am I dropping out then? Am I leaving?
Yes.
Okay. Exit the game, my lord. Great stuff inside. Whoa!
Did you just did you have the ability to add that command, Rovina? Oh yeah, she did. Oh wow, thank you. I should probably make that a mod only capability actually. that's Cambridge Bot. But thank you. Thank you, Rovina. I appreciate that. Actually, you know what? I'm going to modify it slightly. Rovina, I'm going to modify it slightly because... is everyone out, by the way?
I'm out.
Yeah, I am. I think we all are.
All right. I just loaded that back in. I'm going to modify it slightly because we're used to having that at...
And it just totally shut down.
Yeah.
No problem. Let's see.
Put it on the other screen for when I put in the password.
Hey, do you guys want to take like a 5-minute break before we load it up again?
I just got back from home, but it doesn't matter to me, sure.
Yeah, it's fine by me.
All right, my guy's in there, and I'll be back in like 5.
Okay.
Got my green stripes back. Woohoo. Yeah, Aftershock is the title that you did with Shadowrun, right? Yeah.
Yes. Yes, it is. I had a good time with that. Enter a dead world. Just a tyrant. And then we just put out for the first new Shadowrun book in 6 years, Fire and Frost. I keep getting them mixed up. Which should be hitting, it was available at Origins, it'll be available at Gen Con. Fingers crossed it should be available for order on Amazon by August.
Awesome.
Yes, very happy. The first of several. new books coming out. So spread the word, tell people. We can't do it if people don't buy them. That's how it works. So
yeah, I'm missing one of the ones in the set that you did. I think it's number 6.
Fistful of Data by Steve Dedman. Stephen Dedman.
Yes, that's the one I'm missing, because I have Aftershock, Born to Run, Poison Agendas, Fallen Angels, and Drops of Corruption.
Yep, so you're just used the one to complete the set, yep.
And then a whole stack of the classic ones from way back.
Way back, yes, way back when. Yeah, it's hard. I don't want to blame anybody, but it's so, wait, what did you think?
Down.
What did you think of the Kenson trilogy?
I liked all of them for all their different, for all the different angles.
Right. Oh, well, good. Because I guess a lot of people didn't like it because the Kenson trilogy was kind of a little bit more introductory, so to speak.
Right.
And
I'm hoping to see some Defiance novels come out, because that story is actually really starting to get good. I'm a big fan of that show.
Interesting. Okay. Chocolate.
I'm just going to remove Nightbot, and I'm going to add something to Cambridgebot here.
I'm just going to take my 2 minutes while you guys finish up.
Does he speak with a British accent? Of
no, no, well, he does not.
Well, he should.
Let's see. Okay. Please part the channel, Nightbot. Leave the channel.
Arvband.org. Be nice.
Awesome. Yes, thank you very much for giving me the idea too, Rovina.
All right, guys, I'm back.
Okay, cool. Welcome back. Awesome. All right, so Cambridgebot, I think, is now taken over from Nightbot. Because, oh, yeah. All right, and also thank you, Shoutout, for reminding me that I needed to get rid of one of the bots. Too many bots. Yeah, I thought about Brothers: A Tale of Two Sons. I thought about trying that. It was one of those shorter games that was in the middle of a bunch of other games, and I'd already done the To the Moon game, and I did the Samaritan Paradox, which is only a couple sessions. So I felt like I needed to get back to sort of a longer game as well. I think I saw Pixel Monkey actually doing a Child of Light as well. And actually, we are closing in. I see. And actually, we probably should do it now since we're taking a couple of minutes. We are closing in on another giveaway. And so I'm going to do one more giveaway, and that'll leave us one more to do. So this is for a copy of the game you've been watching us play, Warlock 2, along with a copy of the novel that John wrote, the Warlock 2 tie-in novel. And so let us do that. Let's see. Let's see, this one will be... How about I actually spell the word right? This one will be...
Hey, you guys, I'll send this to you as well. You're doing the other giveaway now?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Okay, if you're interested in winning a copy of Warlock 2, and you're interested in winning a copy of the Warlock 2 novel, please type in that word, pita chips. If anyone's curious, this is what they are. Stacy's pita chips. The simply naked kind. made with baked real pita bread. Whole Foods, I believe. The problem with pita chips is they're awfully crunchy, so you have to lean pretty far back from the mic or everyone's going to be like,
yep.
Rip ears.
Yep. Can I join the giveaway? What, no sarcastic comment?
From anybody? No, apparently not. that is crunchified.
Lego, I'm showing this to you right now. Look at that cholesterol number, sir. It says 0. 0%. 0 milligrams of cholesterol.
Well, Swimming High and Awesome. That's funny.
Can you get the book signed to Graydon? Sure. I don't see why not. Just tell me that when you send me the address and I'll send it on to John.
Yes, for any of those who want them, any kind of customized, personalized to whatever, yes, absolutely. That's not a problem. Just, yeah, do include spelling. That will help.
On a very tired night, John spells it like gradient or something. Mm-hmm. Like just,
yep, exactly.
Why did you sign it to this? Okay, so last call. Look at in-game chat. Oh! You're talking to me through a media other than Twitch. What's up, Glob? Nice pita chips. I'm eating them with any dip. I am not eating them with dip. I'm eating them
just
normally.
Justin Bieber's Yeti mother. Alrighty.
Mm-hmm. That's our Glob. It has 0 grams, but it's got 1 kilograms. Yeah, exactly, Gecko. Exactly. Sloth, I'm with you on that. Fresh naan bread with hummus is legit. No question about that. I would not deny that at all. Okay, so we're ending this now. We're closing in on the end. Last call.
Justin Bieber's Yeti mother, what?
Yeah, that's what I saw.
That's Glob Monkey.
So weird, man.
I always suspected, but you know.
I was gonna say he decided to choose something which was as far distant as he could possibly come up with.
Mission
by the way, welcome in any lurkers in there in my stream who I've not seen yet. If you haven't typed anything, welcome in, guys. If y'all are enjoying, it's a chill cast tonight, man. It's a fun game though. I am having a good time with it.
Yeah, it's a good time.
Despite the bugs, I actually am kind of enjoying it myself.
The length of it to get through a full one. I mean, geez, to go through four.
Yeah, that's kind of the only thing I'm like. Yeah,
but I mean, you could speed it up technically and make it just like a minute turn limit or something, and really like race. I don't know what the balance is between how much you have to think and you know.
Yeah, so. Well, see, if you're planning out your moves while the other ones are going.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it wouldn't, once you get the click of things, but I've got like 9 units on the board I need to think about and move around and all this stuff, and it gets kind of complicated. And if we ever get that second city, it's just going to keep growing and growing. You're like, really? I could see a point where 5 minutes is definitely not going to be enough.
Right, yeah. Well, and I mean, that's kind of a problem with all these. This is why people can drop thousands of hours and things. Mm. And I can imagine, I remember playing games, I'm sure Sirius would agree with me on this, playing action-type games, you know, God of War or Revengeance or any one of that, where when you're done with it, it feels epic. For me, like a lot of those are the Assassin's Creed games. But I mean, the Batman games, the Arkham games, but I've only played those, you know, 30 hours maybe it takes to finish one of those. Whereas a Civ game, you know, you drop a couple hundred hours like it's nothing, but it has a different pace, a different cadence.
Right.
So.
Right. Right. That's absolutely. True. Absolutely.
All right. And the winner.
Snap. Kai, are you in here, dude? It's okay. Do it.
Dun, dun, dun.
Ah, Artemis Akana.
Congratulations.
What's up, Stalin? Congratulations, Artemis Akana.
Congratulations, sir.
Congratulations, Artemis Akana. You have won a copy of and the Warlock 2 tie-in novel signed by none other than John Helfers, who happens to be with us tonight.
Happens to be? Well, yes, that's true.
Just happens to be. Okay, and this this is the next-to-last code. We'll have one more of these to give away. And also, thanks to Paradox for, by the way, for sending along the codes. I've already thanked John for, and I will thank him again for setting us up with this. But also, thanks to them for doing that as well. So.
Yeah, well, definitely. You know, it's promo and it's cool, and we're having a lot of fun. And hopefully, some of you guys out there enjoy it. That's the whole plan. So yeah.
So Tiffy, get out of here, man. This ain't your game. Get out of chat, punk. You have like a sub chat going on in here.
This game is pretty sick.
This is like the
giveaway
winners chat.
And yet Glob has not been with all John Helfer's books. That's funny. Burner. Except Burner, you spelled my name wrong. There's only one L in it.
Steals all the books. What's up, Burner?
Okay. Burner, Burner, sir.
So, Optic, is the person that you're attacking in-game, is that actually one of the great mages? Like, are we going to take one of them out?
I don't know.
I think he's a neutral, isn't he? Or is he?
It might be a neutral. I think one of the other mages would probably, you'd know it. It'd have, like, the city. I think it's a neutral city, but we'll
Brown's
find out.
A neutral. Okay. If it's not brown,
okay.
It's okay. Another player.
Okay, so Artemis Akana, that is sent off to you. Thank you very much. And we have now one remaining, one final one, which we'll give away at the end of the night. So we've got one more of the Warlock 2 game/books to give away. And all right, let's get back into it. Start.
Hang on, I'm looking at all these Ruskies who programmed the game. If you go to the credits, which I think is funny.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and then it's a bunch of Norwegian guys who are actually Paradox. But they're a lot of fun. Yeah, I'll have to send him an email at the Tenor tomorrow and let him know how well it went.
Awesome, Burner. That's cool.
Director of Publishing, Thomas Hedenstam.
All right, my turn. All right. Let's do this.
Oh, sorry.
Turn time, series runner.
Okay. Multi. We're going back in, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Since Snap, they left us.
Ooh, donkeys.
Yeah, I'm afraid the donkeys are going to have to... they'll be on their own for a while.
I'm not seeing the game yet.
It's up.
Where is it? Refresh? Let's refresh that bad boy.
Alrighty.
Hey, Kata. Welcome in, sir.
Does it automatically connect? No. Oh, what am I not seeing? Hey. Do I have to... Hold on. What is going on?
Hey, what's up, Kata? Oh, did someone say Kata? Kata. Katabasis! What's up,
Kata,
my friend?
What's up, bro?
How you doing, Kata? Good to see you, man. What's up, man? Welcome into Warlock World, Warlock 2. Good to see you, Kata. Also, hello, Kai. And let's see.
Guys, I'm not in the game, by the way.
You're not?
No, I did not get in, and I can't see it, and I can't join in, which is kind of annoying. So, you know.
All right, I guess I'll have to reload it again.
Sorry.
That's
Bring
strange.
Arf back. Indeed.
I wonder if I could just start it without going back to the main menu. Let me try.
All magic points. Holy. Oh, there's...
There you go. It's your turn. Gosh. John, can you see your turn?
I can't. I'm not in the game at all. All
right. So then
refresh.
There's more of them.
All right, never mind. I'll exit out.
Oh my gosh.
All right, I'm trying again. Multiplayer.
Okay, going in.
Load. Well, there's no game up now, so.
Okay.
Okay, so you see that.
Kai, welcome in, man. This is like Civ, but it's fantasy based.
There's Optic. There we go. Okay, now I got it. Yeah. Boom. There we go. Yes, now I'm in. Now I'm in.
Better get my green stripes.
Waiting for other players.
Yes.
I'm waiting for series 2. Okay.
Oh, for some reason I changed. Wait. Why did I change my picture? I didn't change my picture. Oh, for God's sake.
What the heck?
I haven't started yet.
What the schwants? I did not want that to happen.
Good to see you, Kata, man.
Get back to my deathly guy. There we go. Cripes. Perks are all good. Yes. Boom. Okay.
I know. Well, whose fault is that, Strike Ninja? I was there on Thursday, man. I was there all day. I got there and I did the panel at 3 o'clock, or no, 4 o'clock, with Satobo, and then we went and walked the hall and all that stuff. And I didn't see you either, man. I was there.
Is it the first time you met Satobo in person?
Yes, it was. Nice guy. I met Satobo. I met his fiance. I met his friends. I felt like I had the full Satobo experience.
All right, that guy's a lot nicer on the internet.
No. Oh no, he's a really good dude. That's funny though. I know I was devastated. Guy. The guide to that con was awful. Yeah, that's true. That's definitely true.
Wait, you say the con was awful?
No, the guide to it was awful. There was like figuring out where everything was. The programming was not anywhere near the main conference hall and the exhibit hall and all that stuff. But I am going to be at I'm going to be in Boston next month at ReaderCon. In August, I'm going to be at Gen Con in Indianapolis. John's going to be there too. And then I'm going to be at Wildcat Comic Con and Pittsburgh Comic Con in September. So
hey, Alyssa.
So yes. Okay, blah, 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 blah. Right.
Sod Fearless Alyssa says hello.
So you can see everything now,
G'day,
John?
Alyssa.
You're all set. Okay. Just start when we're ready. Yeah, we're waiting for the players.
Oh, Optics, your wife here. Oh, nice.
Yes.
Welcome in.
Hi, hubby. Oh. Yes.
Wait, the cut scene, the cut pictures, the artwork is really just phenomenal.
Yeah.
That's really awesome stuff. Damn, there we go, and we're back.
I have a lot of Canadians on my stream, Gecko. It's a safe haven for Canadians.
Oh, that turn again?
Yeah, you were screwing up that turn anyway. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. I do the same exact thing I did before.
You botched that turn, like. So we have not run into a great mage yet, at all, right?
We got like 3 worlds to go through. So
we're gonna get into the other worlds, and they're all like burned out wastelands where all the wizards have already like
with huge armies waiting to face us. Now you die. Like, oh great.
Yes, Shadowed has definitely been has been a regular, and not only has he been a regular, but he's actually contributed to the stream as well. Hello, Grocery Boy Jr. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, I had to do a lot of them gray because to promote Icarus, obviously. So a lot of conferences this year. In fact, today I was at my university dropping off some stuff for reimbursement. And all that stuff. So,
stream expenses, you mean?
Yes, clearly. Yes. But anyway, but welcome in everybody. It's good to see you. Yeah, I know you've been gone for a while, Gecko, but I'm glad that you're back. And yeah.
Alrighty.
Good to see you, Grocery Boy. Welcome in. If folks like what you see in here, please make sure to follow. And you're watching Warlock 2 with Series Runner Sod, who is watching over us like an interested father figure, making sure we're good at Warlock 2. But Optic Nerve Productions, Series Runner, John Helfers, and myself playing Warlock 2. And we have one more giveaway of the Warlock 2 game and novel to do.
Absolutely.
All right, let's see if I can put this city under now.
Do it. Take them down.
Yeah, I feel like at this point, you're just waiting for your population to increase so you can keep making stuff.
Yeah, pretty much. Wow, was that nice. Just like magic from above?
Ooh, that was my shadow bolt.
Is it dead? It should be dead. Right?
It looks like it.
You walk through the streets, see if it's as dead as it looks. Calgary, Edmonton, or Saskatoon Expos, yeah.
Just a castle, yeah. Huh.
Oh, for sure. Great. Hey.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Unlocked, hey. Baby.
Wow.
Very ladies cool. and gentlemen, Optic Nerve like a boss with 2 cities.
Nice. Game achievement.
What are your goblins doing to those pigs? What happens in Baconville
cool,
stays
dude.
In Baconville. I will do that, Gray.
Now, can you load your... I guess you can load your settlers on a boat should you eventually get one, right?
I would think so. Just
because
like
there's a certain boat I think you can carry things with. Yes, exactly. That's pretty cool, dude. Very cool. Zeboino has fallen to Optic.
I see you, Fearless Alyssa. Hi.
Okay.
Welcome. So I have not seen you for a little while, actually.
Heal.
My last loud crunching with my pita chips.
Jeez, so obnoxious.
The nerve.
Which I had a... wish I had a frigate that can go and blow up your new Zabuino.
Research complete.
It's at like 2% health.
Level up unit. All these things. Frost weapon enchant. Frost weapon.
Yeah. Be so mean. He's so excited. Whoa, that's a big Medusa pool over there. Be careful. Those things can attack you from distance.
not sure what else.
Hugs.
So I can research something new now? Is that what it's telling me? No, because it still says it's researching fertile lands.
Yeah, that takes forever.
One more turn. It says four. It said it would only take four turns, but it seems like a lot more than four turns.
Yeah, all I know is that I've been researching that forever, and I guess Ceres has been researching for a long time as well. I made sure to be sad by leaving you. Yeah, my bad. New Hamsterdam. That's good, Lord Sloth. New
Hamsterdam.
That's what
great.
I'm talking about. Yep, flying jellyfish. Well, they're actually, I think it's like energy bolts or something. Yep, okay. Good to see everyone tonight.
I guess I just gotta move guys around a little bit.
Work has taken over my life and so have my kids. Yes, our kids, yes. Yeah, I hear you.
I guess that's it, right? Oh, wait, no, can these guys...
That's good. That's a good kind of busy, though, Fearless. Alyssa. There you go.
I can't even see it, but I can attack it.
Mm-hmm. I see it. Looks like a...
I can see the symbol. I can see that it's sea crests or whatever, but it's all still kind of clouded.
Yeah. They don't show... When they say fog of war, they mean it. I'm glad they don't have the, like, fog of war that returns, which I've always found obnoxious. I understand the logic, but it's just...
Oh, new unit.
Come on now.
A new unit's available. Blah, 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 blah.
What's the new unit?
It says Goblin Spearmen, but I already have them.
Hey, Sod, you still here, bro?
Yep.
When you are researching spells and it says research points, what does that mean?
That's basically how many points it costs, and you actually can increase your research points by getting certain buildings.
Yeah. So I only have five, so I can't research.
If you go out of the research panel and just go to the main screen at the very top. There's a little book, and that's got like a plus something.
Boom.
So that's how much research
that is awesome.
You
can go to. That is freaking awesome.
Did you just summon skeletons?
All the way across next to the enemy skeletons. Yes. Yes, I did.
Nice.
Oh, I still don't think I understand what they do, but...
Oh my god. All you see is just skeletons fighting each other. It's just like a mass of bones.
Research points is just a resource. So it costs 60 research points to research that spell. And you have plus five, so you're gaining five research points a turn.
Yeah, I got
it. So if
I
have more research points, it'll take less time to research.
Yes, yes.
Okay, all right, I see how that works. So it's like a multiplier.
Okay.
Okay,
so all right, thanks, Sod. Appreciate it, man.
No problem.
All the AC games are 75% off? Wow.
Yeah, I couldn't do the Steam sale this year, but luckily someone got me Kerbal and Faster Than Light, which were my most two desireds.
Nice.
Faster Than Light, I heard it's pretty good.
Yeah, I want to get it on my iPad too. It's actually pretty fun. Kerbal looks really fun.
Yeah, Kerbal leads to some really, really funny. It's a good one thing to watch. It leads to some really funny stuff.
Alright. Can you guys get over there? You can. Yes, you can. And you will. And you're going to kick some butt.
What's up, Law? Good to see you, man.
Oh, I can't attack him. Son of a diddly. And then you guys are going to come up here. No, you guys are going to come here. Bowmen are useless. Actually, I'm going to put you here anyways. They're there.
Lakota, next D&D thing hopefully is going to be sometime next week. We're working out when that's going to be. We're going to finish up the first D&D pen and paper adventure. And then after that, we're going to play a session of Icewind Dale. And then we'll go back to the... Then we'll go back and do the second adventure for the PNP. So that's the current plan. Yeah.
Awesome.
And I'm sorry for everyone who had a long day, but I'm glad that you're hanging out and chilling with us. We appreciate that very much.
Yes.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. And my bowmen are ready, too. Excellent. Actually, I'm going to put you guys over here. You can just... Oh, and can you get right there? Yes, I can. On the coast. Just kind of hang for a bit, boys.
What is that thing to your... Below you... Is it like a...
Jungle? Silver. It's like silver.
Oh,
I could somehow extend my... Yeah, I've got a lot of resources here. I just can't take advantage of them. And you guys are just kind of sitting.
Waiting for peeps.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, I got my harbor is going to be built in a round, so I think You guys are just going to hang too because there's kind of pointless to go in with.
Glob.
You're all multiplayer game with blackjack and hookers.
Going to take the high ground and you're just going to stay there.
That okay. game already exists, Glob. It's called A Plane Ticket to Vegas.
And I think I'm...
My harbor is built! Huzzah!
This guy's now got a...
How much is this game, guys?
Base price is 30, I think?
I'll check it right now.
It's for sale on 20 right for 20 right now on Steam
there
sale.
There you go. There you go.
Like 21 or something.
Oh, here we go.
Stupid trading cards. Do not care.
Skeletons. Oh, did you take some damage, by the way?
Oh, you got into a car accident, Law? What? Oh, man.
Is the car okay?
Yeah. Oh,
jeez. That's such a dick.
Oh, my God. Dishonored for $5. That's impressive.
And how much are the DLCs? $5 each.
Are they really? That game's totally worth it, though. It's a tremendous game.
I would have gotten the DLCs, but, man.
Black Flag. I should put that on the wish list. I got Dragon Spear was nice enough to get me Remember Me, which I haven't played but have heard good things about, which was on the wish list, which I put up there because of the famous like being part of this red team thing, Steam business.
Right.
And I've never had a wish list. So I was like, I should actually put another game up there that if ever happened, it would be available because I'm not going to play AC4 right away after AC3. But
ow! Oh, you can. Oh, chickens! Oh boy!
You attacked by chickens?
No, the ogre came back out after the skeletons. The frost giant attacked the skeletons, which is very interesting.
I see. That's going to take forever to kill them. I got to bring some more archers over there at some point.
That's what I'm doing.
And now, did he come out like a sucker? Can I put him? Is he within range of my archers? Oh yes, he is. Oh, you're going to so regret that, dude.
Oh my gosh, a teleport spell would be really badass here. I can completely see how a teleport spell would be useful.
It's
okay.
Actually an artifact if you have a mage hero as a teleport staff and you can just teleport every 4 turns.
Oh really?
Pretty crazy.
Oh my god, a war Senpan. Notice me, Senpan.
20 damage. He can take. Oh jeez, I don't want to lose my guy. He's such a kick-ass dude.
Why can I not build this guy?
But I can.
Oh,
because
it costs 100. Jeez, that's why. All right, well, I've got settlers on the way.
Move them up. Move him over. Attack. Move them up. Move them up. Okay, I can try them with... I'll just skeleton them to death. That is what's going to happen.
Yeah, so I definitely am going to have to... Ooh, a tax office. Yeah, I'm definitely going to have to build...
Okay.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to have to build one of these archer things.
Acid Storms, welcome in, man. How are you doing? I'm just trying to understand all the spells and everything and all that, but this is a good game, man. This is Warlock 2. Think of it like Civ 5, but very fantasy and...
Elven Bungalow, for sure.
There's a lot to learn.
Elven, did you say Elven Bungalow for sure? Is that what I heard?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Hi, Fearless. What's up, Alyssa? Yeah, I'm definitely going to do that. I've got to build on... Because I have the Elven Village already. So I'm just going to build the Elven Bungalow there, and that will allow me to build archers and stuff like that, and I need more ranged guys.
That land boat.
Yep.
It's like a medieval Cadillac.
Just needs to be pink.
Pink Cadillac.
Oh, yeah, it's a very interesting game.
Oh, Lord has come.
Ooh,
I got another Lord. Oh.
Oh.
Odin Heavyhoof, Grand Stubborn Master.
Sweet.
There's always one acting Grand Stubborn Master. This has happened because the Chapter of the Order decided to change the rules so it would not be necessary for the knights to clean the hooves of their battle donkeys before battle. According to the traditions of the Order, the Grand Stubborn Master laid his veto on the changes. After discussion, the Chapter decided to choose a new Grand Stubborn Master from the members who supported the change, but at first the old Grand Stubborn Master stubbornly refused to return the seals, and then the new one vetoed the changes in the rules again in support of condition. After assigning 7 more Grand Stubborn Masters in vain, the Chapter changed its tactics and proclaimed the Order would have one acting Grand Master, blah, 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 blah. That's funny. he's got 15 attack, wow, and 4 speed. And he only costs 5 gold a turn. That's a lot better than 17 gold a turn. I think I'm going to get this guy. I guess I'm not going to because he costs...
Buku money?
I guess. Oh, 150. Yeah, all right. Well, I'll take care of that as soon as I get some coin. Thanks for letting me know.
Well, that's why I have money, because I finished my harbor. Yay! Score. Harbor is a good thing. All right.
I have a new unit. Oh, I know that. I know I have a new unit, darn it. Stop confusing
me. I don't feel
me,
like man. I've finished building anything yet.
All right. Settler.
It is my turn.
It's going to be amazed.
Oh, man.
Saad, is there a way to, like, if you double-click on the settlers, because I have settlers that just appeared in my city, and I can't seem to select them without selecting the city.
I use the unit panel.
I thought about that, but it doesn't seem to... It doesn't seem to do that. Or maybe maybe that is something I have to do on my turn. I hope I didn't waste a turn then doing them.
Is that Kraken like healing itself or something? What the jeez?
Yeah, probably. That's why I put my bears next to it.
Yeah,
I can't get to mine.
I don't think mine is healing. Actually, I probably should be sure about that. Where's the Kraken? There he is. Yeah, no, I'm killing him gradually.
All right.
Wow, you got airbags deployed, huh?
Letters. Okay, is there anything else I can do here?
Holy crap, next turn.
60 melee resist before armor upgrades. Pure tank. Alright.
That's good there.
That's what I like to see. I will hire that guy.
No wonder she's going crazy. Okay.
I can handle 5. 150, not so much. Oh my god, only 2 turns to fertile lands. Be still, my not fertile land.
Deployed airbags, that's funny.
Am I gonna do this? I guess I could.
So, if I can do all this, I can take this guy out. 39 left. He does 17.
Alright, gentlemen.
7-7-7.
My turn took 2 minutes. I'm getting better.
We're speeding
nice.
Up.
Nice.
Saad, I'm sorry. You said that when you get a group of spells together, the spell group research thing, what does that do when those circles are filled?
It allows you to get to the next tier of spells. It'll automatically move you to the next tier.
I see. Oh my
but
god.
You can go back by using the arrows.
Yeah, go ahead and keep scrolling on the spells, bro. See how many there are.
Oh my.
Yeah, it's crazy.
There's a red dragon. I can summon a red dragon?
Right now,
in
I got
25 years.
A quest called exactly. Grand Hunt. It says, "Your Highness, a terrible monster has appeared in your lands. It scares people and traitors. I'm sure it's a good opportunity to show your citizens how brave their Caesarian can be. Order to kill the monster, and your glory will be eternal." See that already? Eternal, guys. Eternal.
There you go, man. Exactly.
Eternal glory. It's hunting time. I chose.
There you go.
Absolutely.
That's right. I
have no idea what it's going to do.
You're gonna kick some ass. That's
they send you out right, like, you know, naked in a loincloth with a sling. All right, go get him. Like, wait, oh god.
When you complete the quest, you get the reward of 250 gold and sign of time, whatever that means.
250 gold.
I think that might be an artifact. That might be some sort of like artifact. I don't quite remember.
And I gotta find where these polar wargs showed up. Oh, I see it.
Your parrots seem to be happy about it.
Yeah,
right?
They really are.
I know, right, Ravina? Turns are getting faster and a turn-based strategy broken.
That's true, isn't it?
Yeah, I see a little quest thing, but I don't know.
The loincloth is your sling. You start whirling it around your head. You don't fire those balls, you fool! Extra damage to yourself.
Nice. Nice.
This is only a testicle of my true power.
Oh my gosh.
I'm sorry. It was just there for the taking.
That was awesome. Yeah. And you took it, of course.
Oh, man.
Boom.
I can't see what you're...
That's my main... When something's close enough to your towers, I can attack from my main tower and my mage tower.
Oh, cool.
They'll have arrow symbols on them.
Yeah, I saw that with my thing. I just wondered what you were attacking.
Oh my god. Yeah, what
it looks
attacking?
Invisible. It just looks like what are
those
you
those were my that was where the grand wargs were, and I just killed them and won the quest.
Oh, okay. Okay. So they those are the ones that just appeared. So they were like, there's a great hunt. So you like casually walk up to the top floor of your tower and you're like, click, and it just like fires a bunch of ballistas. You're like, right, can I have my money, please?
Damn. Nice.
I still don't know where to move these guys.
Yeah, make sure you take care of that law. Like, don't let that, if it continues to hurt, don't just try to be the tough guy, because that stuff can be serious if you don't get it attended to, and if you do get it attended to, it can be all right, but... And Lakota, yes, I've played XCOM. Good game. I played it probably about 8-9 hours. It's just, I had played it right after I'd finished Mass Effect, and I was kind of spaced out, like, literally and figuratively. I was, like, too much space stuff. I needed a little bit less of it, so I may get back to it at some point.
Fire damage, 8 death magic, and life magic.
Nice, man. You got some good damage there.
Let's see. I think that's everybody moved, right? Oh, I gotta research a spell. Now I can only pick the blue ones, correct?
Welcome back on Mobile Law. See you, Glob.
Yeah, I think only the blue ones until you research the one behind it. Is that right?
Gotcha.
What's up, Red Pain? Welcome in. You've been putting in some hours on XCOM? Yeah, I mean, I liked it. It was a cool game, but...
Alright, that should be good. Oh, I gotta level up a unit now. Holy cow. Assign unit orders.
The heck is flipping out in your house, Optic?
That's my Prince of Wales.
Ah.
Oh, awesome, Trend. Thanks so much, man. That's very cool. Very cool. I hope you enjoy it. Ah, all right.
John helps.
See if I can turn my mic down a little bit.
Awesome, Trend. Glad.
Yep. All right, spell ready. It's time to kill a freaking ogre. Aw, yeah. All right, check this action out. Let's see.
Is there a petting zoo? At Optic's house, there is.
Pretty much.
Optic is not screw around when it comes to animals.
You know what? We're going to test this out. Going to do some melee resistance on this unit. Oh, wait, I can't? No, really? I can't cast
it. I still haven't played Mass Effect. I have it, but I've never played it.
I think you would like it. Mass Effect is a tremendous series. Really is a tremendous series. Wow. Skeletons are like, you have a lot of skeletons, but your skeletons are like.
I have not yet begun to fight, my friend. I have.
Yeah, you can definitely take this guy out, dude. Look how many guys you have.
Oh my gosh, your freaking sharpshooter guy is amazing.
He is, dude. He's unreal. Beat the crap out of him.
He waits for like the fodder of the skeletons, and then
he's like Mark Wahlberg and stuff.
Yeah. Then I got my backup guys, but it gets even better. Check this out. Beat him. And then I bring in the archers. Oh yeah? Check this action out.
Loose.
Fire! Critical hit minus 6. He's the problem is guy is still up.
He's wielding a tree, I just noticed. It's the first time I noticed that he just like wields an entire tree.
Actually, the funny thing is I can bring in everybody. Every single
freaking everybody.
Boy. And I haven't played XCOM since it looked like I Sims 2.
Oh yeah.
XCOM was alright. It was a little too random for me.
The original XCOMs, I loved them. Like Under the Deep, all those, or Terror of the Deep.
Yeah.
Those. I loved them, but that was a long time ago.
I didn't like the random either, and there was one mission that really, really ticked me off. That I was like, yeah.
Well, I can't. He's down to 9 points. I cannot get him any lower. I hope he doesn't leave his frickin'. Well, I can shoot him if he goes back to his thing, so I guess I'll have to kill him next round. That sucks. Try and kill him off, but I can't. They can't reach him in time. Or can they? No, they can't. There's too much in the way. And this is swamp. Just can't get to him. But I'm gonna bring him up anyways. Just so they'll be ready to take him if they can.
I mean, I've been lucky in that in that sense, Rovina, in that I don't generally play any more games that I don't, you know, that I don't like, because people have been nice enough to give me games that they think I will like, and I make it clear that if it's not my kind of game, I'll just give it away. But there's definitely games out there, like, for example, as I'm looking, I stopped playing Fallout New Vegas. I think it's a good game, but it just wasn't my thing. I don't like new post-apocalyptic settings to begin with, and it just wasn't. I stopped playing Jade Empire. I felt like Jade Empire was... It was like Knights of the Old Republic and a lot less interesting. And it's too bad, because I really would like to have a sort of martial arts style RPG, but I thought it was repetitive and it was not my deal. So that was another one that I thought was oversold, honestly. And let me see, what was the other one? I'm just scrolling down my list of these things. I have to say that I thought Transistor was a little disappointing, because I felt like Well, it's hard, because it's hard to say, because I think it's a really gutsy game, and I think it's really stylish, and I think the art and the music is really beautiful, but it felt like it didn't totally gel for me based on what I was expecting. So I wouldn't say it's a bad game, but based on what the hype that it had received, I wasn't sure about that. And then all of the Spiderweb games, I'm just looking at some. I think it was actually Guilt who was nice enough to give me these, because they were pretty cheap as a bundle, but all of these, Avedon, Avernum 4, 5, 6, Escape from the Pit, I don't get what people see in them, I'm sorry. I understand that they're like amazingly deep and all that, but the graphics are so bad. I mean, Avernum 4, 5, 6, like all those kind of games.
This coming from a guy that streamed in television.
Hey, listen, but I, you know what I mean? The thing about that is, though, you can get through, I mean, you know, granted, that's a nostalgia thing, but I think some of those hold up better, because those games are done within an hour, 45 minutes, you know? And like, this just goes on and on and on and on. Ugh. Just not my thing at all, so.
You're weak against trees. I'm going to kill that ogre next round. He's going down.
I'm curious. That's funny. I am weak against trees. You make a good point, sir. They were making fun of me for not being able to handle
PC real fast.
Climbing a tree in Assassin's Creed. All right. I wonder if I can hit those wild serpents.
I was three, by the way.
Oh, you got
it. It's good. I like it. It's not as good as the others. I can see why people say that, but I think it's gotten a lot of irrational hate it doesn't deserve.
Gotcha. Critical hit.
Level up. If I'm still getting experience points from this, I mean, I'll just keep leveling up.
Yeah.
Like a boss. Okay. Let's do dodge. Let's see. Endurance. That sounds good. Experience per turn plus one. No, I want these guys alive. Let's have them dodge.
That's the same one I did.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I want like one of my bear's upgrades to be like extendy claws, so they can like reach out over the water.
That's hilarious.
Level up?
I think they do. Yes, they did actually, because they leveled up once already.
There you go.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, it was, you know what it is? It's again, now New Vegas is not a bad game. Don't get me wrong. In no way am I saying that. It's just bleak, bleak, bleak. I can't, you know, I just was like, I couldn't deal with yet another example of more bleak. I just was like, I don't know. So
New Vegas was the first game I got all the achievements on, I think.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, gosh, there's guys. Hunters.
It was fun, but I can see what you're saying. Everything's brown.
Well, yeah, it's just, I don't know.
No, seriously, it's in a desert.
Yeah, no, I mean, it is. You're right about that. But I mean, like, it's just, it's one of those things where you're like, man, really? Like,
the exploration is why I liked it so much. But.
Yeah, for sure. And there were some good, like, I love the ghoul mission, without spoiling anything, the mission that to go to the land beyond or whatever it's called. You know what I'm talking about?
I haven't played it in a long time. I probably would, but it's fine.
Yeah, I like that too. Had I played Bastion prior to playing Transistor? Yes, I had, Rovina, and I loved Bastion. It was one of my top games 2012. So yes, admittedly, that may have something to do with it. I wouldn't say that Transistor was a badly put together game. And as I say, there's some moments of it that are really beautiful. And I really, really admire Supergiant as a studio. I think for them to do a game like that, because it's true, it just throws you in and you just have to kind of figure it out. And I give them credit for that. I just don't think it all gelled together, and I didn't think it was tied together as well as Bastion was, in my view. So, what's up, Firemaster? Yes, Civ 5 is, I imagine, an enormous influence. In fact, I heard someone saying that there were some people yelling about that over in the forums. I'm not just talking, by the way, I'm also looking at my stream to, looking at my game to see what I'm supposed to be doing here.
Must kill him. Must kill. Let's get into that.
Almost got the fertile lands thing. How many more turns? One more turn? Still two more turns? I thought I already had two more turns. Why? Why you take so long for the lands? This game is nothing like this.
Why didn't AC1 get an HD remaster? I'm sure they have plans for it.
Oh yeah.
But that was Assassin's Creed 1 was on PlayStation 3 though, wasn't it? It was on
no.
that gen.
No. I think it was PS2. Wasn't Assassin's Creed on PS2?
Are you serious?
I think so. Maybe I'm wrong. I might be wrong.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't actually know. Let me see. Alright, what's going on here? Let's see.
Oh, really, Certifi? I wasn't aware of that.
You like the genre of games? Yeah, Musky Bear.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I know some people who are big Civ 4 folks that don't want to move up to Civ 5 either, Shadowed. It's got a little bit of the D&D edition problem where, you know, particular edition devotees don't want to switch to something else. And they're like, no, Civ 3 is the best. No, Civ 4 is the best. The game died after Civ 2, you know. So it's like,
yep.
I imagine that is there something similar like that in the action stuff series, like in God of War?
Oh,
is there
yeah.
one that you're like,
God of,
some
not
people,
War,
it's like
their
debate about like God of War 2 versus 1 or like.
No, I mean, I don't know about God of War, but Devil May Cry definitely fell down that path.
Yeah, yeah. Which was the one that you were really getting frustrated, the Devil May Cry, that you were like, what? Why? There was one of them that you were like
getting
not,
frustrated on?
Well, you just were disappointed. Or well, maybe it was a Castlevania. There's one of the series that you usually play that you were like, I can't believe this game came out and did this instead of this other thing.
Oh, I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember which one it was, but
yeah.
Lords of Shadow 2 was Mosky Bear's number one disappointment. Was that the one that you weren't
no,
wild
no,
about
no,
Lords
no,
of Shadow
2? No, 2 was good. 2 was good. I like Lords of Shadow 2. I'll think a little bit harder once I'm done with this turn.
Yeah, sorry.
Oh, is this your new strategy? Is like bringing my concentration by
we're working
so
as an alliance.
What
you're
is
so you're so his competitive juices are so high that he's like, oh, what co-op?
Joking.
Like we're gonna start co-oping when we start co-op Divinity Original Sin and be like, hey, look what I found out. And he's gonna like slap it out of my hand. He's like, oh, sorry, sorry, about that. You just broke the sacred artifact. You're like, yeah, I'm sorry, I just saw it. And
oh man, all right, that's going.
All those people love SimCity and they know it, right, Strike? You mean the new SimCity? Oh, God, man.
That's a fun game, though.
About that one.
Yeah, after the numerous the things that they did to it. Xano still like spits what every time he talks about EA because of what they did to SimCity.
Let's see what they do to Sims 4.
All right, we got that going.
Yeah.
That's going to get ready to grab.
Dark Souls 2 underperformed for all the hype people gave it. Well, I mean, the obvious
That's
one
true.
There is Watch Dogs, right? I mean, I haven't played it, but I don't see how that game could succeed given all the hype, which is a little unfair, you know.
I don't know. Everyone bashes it. It's one of my most enjoyable titles as of late.
Yeah, so, I mean, you know, that's it. I mean, expectations do have a lot to do with it.
It's one of the very few games in the last, I couldn't even tell you how many years that I sat down. I was like, I'm getting every one of these achievements. That's just all there is to it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm missing one.
Yeah. No, that's cool.
And Watch Dogs?
Yeah, I love Watch Dogs. It's the damn drinking game achievement. Oh, my God.
I felt like I was playing in Assassin's Creed 3. There's this one section optic where you go into Desmond's world again. And I swear I was like, this is Watch Dogs. Like, this is set up for Watch Dogs. The same studio. You know, there's like just a lot of the stuff I'm like Watch Dogs vibe.
Right.
You know, so
I think it sets the stage for a good new series.
Oh, I took 3 minutes. Dang it.
Yeah, for sure.
Relax. What's up, man?
See how some of the DLC turns out, stuff like that.
Well, people forget that AC1 got bashed when it first came out because everyone said, oh, there was all this hype. But that led to a tremendous series. You know,
exactly. Every time I love Black Flag, and every time I put in AC1 on my 360, I can't get past 5 minutes to play it. I just take it out. I'm like, meh.
Yeah, I
but
like
I'll it. Play the other one for hours.
I liked AC1, but definitely I wouldn't want to go back to it now. I mean, the Ezio trilogy for me is super. I think Revelations is unbelievable. In fact, I think Revelations is even a little underrated. I think the Constantinople world, the just a lot of the hook shot, a lot of this, or what, not the hook shot, whatever it's called, the hook blade thing.
I stopped playing after Brotherhood.
So stylish.
Stream,
Revelations is great. I think you would like Revelations. Yeah, that I'm confident you would like.
Okay.
Just such a cool. It's such a cool story. Ezio is just such a great character. It's really what it comes down to. He's such a great character.
He is pretty cool.
He's got so much personality. Just like that's what you want. And I think that's why Connor, the AC3 protagonist, suffers. I don't actually think Connor's that bad. I think he's a good protagonist in a way, especially given his backstory as to why he acts the way he does. But it's like, he's
just
sort
not like
of
Ezio.
Sullen and bitter, and like he's just not Ezio. I mean, like, so, you know.
Yeah, Herlocks, it is so good to see you, man. Congratulations on graduating high school, man. What are your plans now?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Let me ask him. It's awesome, man.
I can't construct anything.
Yeah, that does suck when you can't build anything. Like,
yeah, for sure, Burner. I agree.
I think my bird just pooped on me.
All right.
Delightful.
Yeah.
The bird is like, that's what I think of how you're playing. Blam.
Suck it.
Yeah, I would get Black Flag, but I still need to play Revelations and...
Well, Black Flag has nothing to do with any of the other ones, so you don't have to play them.
But, well, yeah, but if you want to finish the Desmond story...
yeah, no, I
that you definitely need Revelations in 3. And 4 right, is slightly connected optic to 3. I mean, because of stuff, reasons.
Do not spoil
it. Hey, Rascal, welcome in, sir.
But I know what you're saying. But like, it's not as connected for sure.
Black Flag being 50% off is pretty good. $20
yeah,
is. Of course, the DLC is like probably twice as much as the actual game.
Yeah, some of the DLC is pretty much standalone, too. It's pretty decent.
I'm going to have to decide when I get through AC3 whether I want to play the Washington, George Washington DLC. A lot of people hate on that, too, and I have to decide if I want to do that or not.
I don't even know where to move my guys now because I don't have anything I can do but wait till I can build a boat.
Hey, you need a harbor, dude. I think that's...
Yeah. your guys have literally like just spread out over the whole island just bumping into each other.
I kind of know where he can go. It's true. It's
Why
all...
don't you go east, though? You haven't really gone east.
Well, I'm moving this one unit over there, but it's a dead end. It's a little point with some Medusa down there that I'm going to try to kill, I guess.
Yeah, maybe there's like a trampoline you can bounce over. I don't
yeah,
know,
like
I have no
someone
idea.
Picked continents as the map type.
That's right, Lakota. Yeah, yeah we exactly. Go. Well, we talked about that, Lakota. I thought that was pretty interesting.
All right, spell ready.
I like that very much.
Oh, spell ready. All right, someone's pissed off over there.
And if you didn't know, Rascal, we are chilling over at this chat right here.
Yeah, we got 60 folks in here right now, so thanks, everybody. And
again,
if you like
awesome.
What you see in here, please make sure to hit that follow button. And please follow all of these gentlemen. Series Runner, who's back casting again, which is great. He's a really good caster. We missed him here. Optic Nerve Productions also has had a lot of IRL stuff, which is now cleared up. And he's, as he said, back to business. So he's a guy you should be following as well. And obviously Saad, who has been helping us out as our sensei, as it were. Another very good streamer. And John Helfers is the guy that you should be listening to when we play our D&D sessions and also checking out his writing and editing work. And yours truly. And by the way, one other announcement too. A week from now, Thursday, July 3rd, I'm going to be interviewing Sarah Bayless, who's one of the writers for Divinity Original Sin from Larian Studios. So I'm going to be playing some of that while I interview her. And then the next day, Friday, July 4th, yours truly and Series Runner will be co-oping that game, which I'm really looking forward to because it looks like a tremendous game with an excellent story. So
it's going
to
be so much fun, dude.
Yep, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Wait.
I'm really looking forward to it, man.
Yeah.
What's up, Chocolate Ice Cream Show? Attack something. I would be happy to do that, sir, if it were my turn. But John is the one who's going to attack right now. Oh, with
yes!
the back shot. Yeah.
Took him down.
Jesus. Homie's down.
Thank you for the follow, Trendane. I appreciate that. That is awesome.
Dude just leveled up
Beautiful.
Again. Unbelievable.
That
Arrow
guy's
suppression.
Legit. Okay, now move your soldier in there. Or your
Eat
snow
your
skulls.
Turn. Oh, we're taking poison pikes on that bad boy. 50% death magic. Are you kidding? That's a no-brainer. All right, gotta keep you guys. Can I heal my dudes? Give you some heal undead? Yes. Nope.
We actually were talking about that, Mosky Bear, the other day, about how few Native American protagonist characters there are. There's a few, but not enough. So it's true. It's another reason to like Connor.
How do you gain reputation with a certain god?
I think you can build a shrine to them in the city,
the
right?
Shrines.
Stop? Yeah,
shrines.
Yeah, you get a certain amount of viewers, and then they'll offer you a sponsorship.
What, we can't. What? No attacking? I need a point left to attack. That sucks.
You get there and you just glare at him menacingly.
Yeah, pretty much.
Did they expand Divinity a lot since Alpha? I have no idea.
I was pretty impressed with watching the early access version. I've seen a fair amount of that, so.
I am probably still going to regret that, but it was worth it.
Why did that do that? Oh, let's
see. Right. My other guys, they have no movement. Who am I missing? At least I took out Moron freaking that ogre boy. Jeez.
Ogre boy.
I've been
ogre my way.
Now it's
your
ogre
skeletons
body.
Are really strong.
They're not that. They're not.
No, it's the freaking sharpshooter that like is just badass.
What I was thinking is the reason is not because they, they're good for taking damage, so your archers can comfortably sit behind them.
That is true. I don't want to kill my.
Actually, that's true. A sharpshooter plus a couple of archers and those skeletons is pretty OP. Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah,
this
just
guy's
the
down. Oh boy, I'm just gonna have to take the chance to not have my guys charge in there and get killed.
Afraid, but that's funny.
All right, I think I'm done.
Yes, for sure, Lakota. It would be cool, but I have a feeling Lakota. They're not gonna go back to that for a while because they've done this now. They're going the French Revolution. There's a lot of talk about Russian Revolution. There's a lot of talk of getting Japanese or Chinese culture in there, and also getting. I still want Victorian England in AC. I still think. Victorian England would be awesome. Oh man, Optic! What is going on with Optic's internet?
I don't know, man. This guy is probably gonna. Oh, he's only 12 damage. Okay.
Well, just finish up yours, John, and then.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty much done. I just want to make sure there's nothing else I can do. No. All right. Yoink. Okay, I'm done.
All right. As soon as they're done, we'll say whoa.
Well, the monsters are going.
Whoa, air elementals.
Ow. Ooh, okay, he drove him out. That's fine.
Oh, hey, don't fire on me!
Oh,
bastards.
That hurt.
Fired on my settlers.
Oh, I missed the monster turn.
I'm gonna have to cover that. Alright.
It was chaos.
Let me save it. Save.
No, I'm looking forward to Divinity for sure, Acid Storms.
Ouch.
Seems like my kind of game, and doing it co-op is having the game built for co-op is it just sounds awesome.
Yep, agree.
Oh, that was a mistake, Mr. Polar Giant. That was a big mistake you made.
All right, Optic.
All right, so we're backing out.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. You saved it and everything, right?
I did save it. Yes. Shadowed. I don't know. Probably not a whole lot longer, but we'll see. I'm not entirely sure.
Free stuff inside.
Okay,
free stuff in the store, guys.
I got my free stuff.
I got it. It's like more voiceover things.
Yeah. It's
cool.
Yeah. Things, right?
Maybe I should get it.
Yeah. What are we? 11:50.
There's series. Now we're waiting for John and etc. Actually, is Optic back on Skype yet?
I don't know.
Cross power.
He said he lost power.
Optic's on. You, me, and our view, me and him, right now.
Oh, yeah, there he is. He's not on Skype, though.
Well, details. But I'm still not seeing the game. I'm not seeing the game yet.
No, I haven't put it up yet. I was waiting for the rest of you to go.
All right. Well, fine.
Co-op's seriously more fun than solo. Absolutely.
No question about that, Acid Storms, in general. I hope this is a trend of more people figuring out. Like, I was so excited when AC Unity supposedly had co-op. I'm like, yes, co-op! And then there's, like, a couple of separate missions. I'm like, oh. Why don't you just make a freaking campaign you can do co-op, please?
It would make more sense.
God,
yeah, exactly.
It's just a lot
more
fun.
That would be the game for it, too.
Yeah, Unity, you know? So, all right. So is everyone able to join up?
Yep, I think we're all in.
Everyone's in? Okay.
Okay.
Hey, Sod, what turn are you on?
105.
Wow. You did 80 turns in, like, the last hour and a half or something?
Oh,
yeah, get some sleep, Shadow.
It's just him versus, what, four AIs? or just you yourself?
Yeah, I'm up against. I'm doing the campaign mode, and I'm against two other AI.
Okay. Yeah, so the AI is going to go zip zip, we're done. So
I finally researched. Oh my gosh, be still my beating heart. I finally researched this thing.
Cast it. It must be cast.
All right, yeah, I'm going to cast it. I shouldn't cast right now. All right, fertile land.
Where are you casting it?
Wait. What the
heck? I see this. I'll just level see this unit. As you create your fertile land.
Yeah, no, Blacklist was good, and having separate co-op missions was pretty awesome.
There we go, yeah, that was weird.
Blacklist.
Welcome back.
I was trying to call the group, and it kept saying no answer.
Okay, I was like, yeah, what? Still working on that Kraken.
Spider hatch, that's funny.
Sign unit orders. Still not letting me attack it.
We'll shoot arrows all week!
Oh, I don't want to intern, drunk. Alright. Yes, I want the settlers to stay right there where they can be slaughtered by the hunters. Actually, why did I do that? That was really dumb. That was really dumb. Alright, I'm going to move my settlers out of the way. Let's go this way. And you guys are going to produce... I still need more gold, man.
What are these guys? These are... hunters. Oh.
Yeah. Who decided to hunt my settlers, which...
Well, you know. Target of opportunity, bud.
It was a target-rich environment.
That's right.
I am going to... I'm sort of torn between wanting to create... Okay, that's almost done, so he must have been, I don't know what he was talking about. Anyway, I'm torn between wanting to create Gray Striders and go down and take them out, and wanting to wait so I can build, well, I guess it's only 2 gold. I'm just worried about the amount of money, because it's going to cost a lot of money to hire that hero, and like, I don't know. I'm gonna build
a ruler. A ruler who's always worried about his budget is no ruler at all, Arv. You know that.
Yeah, I'm gonna build him too. Yes. To make a good point.
That's right. Gold's there for the spending. Of course, I dipped a little below 80 like one time because I don't need to pay a lot of people. Skeletons don't draw no money. Don't draw no salary.
Okay, so we're gonna leave them there. The hunters are not gonna be able to fire from there. And also, you've signed your death warrant, hunters. Just letting you know.
Just give me 2 turns, get these guys up and running, and you're gone.
So you know you're in big trouble, yes.
They're coming. They're coming.
Okay. And yes, this is the same world as Majesty, Crate Hollow. And, yeah, I don't know if it was the same one, but it might be. We actually had Crate Holio, the voiceover guy, George Ledoux, was in here talking about that.
That was very nice.
Today.
Very cool guy. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And enter. Research, damn you, research. You're upstairs.
Alright, is this Kraken finally going down? I got 2 archers, man, come on.
Could this be the time? 15, nope, he's still got yellow. We got a bunch of yellow there.
We got archers on the other side, though.
Yeah, I know, but... he's getting one more round.
I like how you're firing from the pumpkin patch. Fire up, Zulu!
That's right. Take cover in the pumpkins, good sirs.
You can attach some pumpkins to the arrows and do extra blunt damage.
Pumpkin bombs.
That's right.
That's exactly what I was thinking, Trendane. That's exactly
Hobgoblin
right.
Hobgoblin style.
Yeah.
Look at a little land isthmus there. It's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, it's how I invade. Now, what is that thing up there? This is... Ice Elements Pillars. Oh, jeez.
Oh, that in the bottom right, that's Ice Australia. You're stuck there forever.
Don't you mean just Ice Australia in general?
Yes, it's Ice Australia.
Sod, your thoughts.
No comment.
But you're so close to meeting my people. Like, there's a little bit more cloudiness, although there's still an ocean there in the way, so you gotta cross that somehow.
Was it Total Annihilation, Burner?
I feel like they're going to film the next episode of Alaska State Troopers next to my castle.
Man.
It almost is a good Australia shape, too.
If I told her I just summoned a rainbow dragon, what would you say?
That's pretty kick-ass.
Right?
I'd say, what's that from Neverending Story?
Da da da. Falcor.
Falcor.
Yeah, you had the kid on the back of them. Yeah! Good movie. Underrated movie. Even if the queen was the creepiest character of all time.
Alright. Details.
Still
details.
Great. That wolf, oh man, I actually used that on a panel at Origins, that the image of that wolf staring out of the shadows towards the end of the Neverending Story freaked me out as a kid.
And I don't care what its orientation is at all.
StarCraft
2 minutes.
Is
a love
game
it.
I've never played.
StarCraft is hard.
Yeah, I do remember Warlords, for sure. Warlords is a good game, actually.
StarCraft was fun. StarCraft 2, oh my god, I got stuck on StarCraft. Oh, it's just a nightmare.
I played like midway through StarCraft and didn't. Again, it wasn't as cool as the Warcraft stuff. I got all the way up to Warcraft 3, like midway through, and then stopped.
I enjoy StarCraft because of the Protoss. They're my favorite group to play.
Oh, yes, for a Dune. I love the
Protoss. Yes, oh, awesome. But, oh, the Zerg, man. Holy cow.
Yeah, the Zerg.
Welcome in, Moski. How are you doing, man? Yeah, Double Dragon Neon, man. That game was, I enjoyed it. I think it got terrible reviews, but it was quirky.
Double Dragon Neon.
Yeah. They tried a little too hard to be funny, but it was still cool.
Alright.
I can move down. Oh, do I actually have... Oh, that's a white line. White line.
I wonder if I can build...
Damn.
Visions, dreams of passion. All the while,
everything's so expensive. Monies.
I will loan you some monies.
Man, it's just... this war senpan thing.
Yeah, dude, Moski, you're always welcome, man. This is a very different... I mean, this is a special cast. This is a special Warlock 2 Civ 5 co-op. Hanging out with Arvin Elleron, John Helfers, and Optic. And Sod. So we're all in here just jamming.
It's a good
talking,
time.
Chilling.
It's a good time.
Yeah. I am very much enjoying this.
Yeah.
Cool, man. Yeah,
I'm just confused.
Yes. Yeah, you seem to be trapped until you can get... I mean, you got all this stuff. That's the thing. It's like, man, this dude's, like, loaded.
My life for ire. I just thought the Protoss were such a well-put-together race.
I have nowhere I can bring my settlers. They can. They are unsettled.
My wife for hire. My wife for hire.
Your continent is really small, Optic.
It's controllable.
It's controlled.
Why don't
you make the SS Botany
pass.
Bay? Yeah, yes, it's Botany Bay.
Gotta get. I'm surprised he hasn't been able to build a harbor. That's what freaks is like. What? Why not? Come on. I mean, two cities, coastline galore.
That's true. Can you not build a harbor?
He's got pigs.
I don't see an. I've got pigs. I've got pumpkins. I've got two farms. I've got a ratman guild, a goblin guild, a market. I don't see any option to make this here.
Try it on your.
Yeah, when I go in there and I go to harbor. I can't click anything. Nothing under buildings can be clicked.
Your population, you must need your population to be bigger.
Population isn't high enough on that.
I can't raise my population because we've got no more land to populate.
So why not build a settler and move the settler out to that little peninsula and create a city for the express purpose of just doing a harbor?
No, your population goes up anyways, dude. Don't worry about the farm. It raises regardless.
Because that's not 4 hexes away. I have to. Yeah. So you have to be at least 4 away.
Exactly.
There's no hex on my island that's 4 away for my settlers to land on.